I'm gonna do some doodling in this dotted notebook with just like Crayola markers because these are like very light. And then I really want to like do some painting. I have this, what's it called? A gouache palette. This is actually my sister's. Apparently these were trendy. But yeah, I used to do a lot of watercolor and acrylic back in the day, so I feel like this shouldn't be too bad. I did test it out yesterday. And yeah, I feel like it would be fun to use it today. Actually, I should show you some of my old watercolor pictures if you're interested. Okay, so yeah, this was like several years ago. Watercolor, I like using a lot of blue on my watercolor. It's another old one. Ooh, I actually really like this one I did because I actually put in effort. This was around the time that, of course, they announced the remake of the Ruby and Sapphire, and I was just so excited, and I drew this. I really like this, actually. This, I don't know why I did this. This is more of like a sketch turned to watercolor. Again, a lot of blues. I really like using blues. This was actually from high school, so this one's a little older. This was for my art class. Focusing. It better be focusing. I actually have no idea what to draw. I just want to draw like cutesy stuff. Alright, but you know, that's the point of doodling, improvising and stuff. Alright, so for this doodle, I'm starting out with a bunny, you know, just going with the flow. I'm using a 0.3mm Pentel pen to do a sketch, and I'm just gonna go over it with this Crayola marker. So Crayola markers are cool because they're very light. It just sucks to color with them because, you know, they're Crayola markers, so like the colorful markers bleed through the black marker and it just isn't a good look. So I'm using this watercolor pencil as sort of like a texture. It's actually for watercolor. Like, it's one of those pencils where you color it and you put water on it. So this is meant for watercolor, but I use it as like a normal color pencil anyways, just because it's very soft, and I'm just using this for some texture. I usually like to mix my media, and I'm just trying to balance out the picture with some flowers and some patterns. So yeah, I don't know if people usually like to watch like the whole thing. I've been just kind of like chopping it up and just clipping like certain parts. So yeah, here's this little doodle. Okay, so next doodle, I didn't use a pencil to outline it at all. It's really just all improvising. I really had no idea what I was doing. It's really fun to doodle with Crayola markers. I love doing it, especially because they're just so fun and easy to doodle with. I was just doodling some animals, you know, some Animal Crossing vibes. Just doodling away and then just coloring in the spots with like these primary colors kind of feel, you know. And I kind of messed up in one of the corners, so I had no choice but to frame this one with a black outline as well. It's a little bit like off balance, but you know, it's still kind of good. It's kind of my fault for not really using pencils to outline it, but yeah, here it is. We are done with both the doodles, and now we're gonna move on to some painting. I cut up the watercolor paper into smaller squares, and I'm just going to use the back of that watercolor pad for the surface. And I'm using mask tape to secure the paper to give it that frame look in the end. Also, I apologize for this awful angle. This is the first time I'm doing this, so I'm still learning. And I'm so sorry that it looks so bad. Time to sketch out what I want! I just love how thick gouache is. It dries faster than watercolor, and it's so good if you want a cute, solid look. Also, the paint brushes I'm using aren't anything special, literally just like $7 at the art store. Okay, so I just decided that I wanted this to be a cute strawberry plant picture. Just something cute and basic so I don't mess up on my first recording. What I really like about gouache is that it's easier to mix the colors and it's not too watery, but you can always adjust how watery you want it. It's a much more thicker look and you can always apply other layer of paint on top really quick because of how it dries. Compared to watercolor, where you have to be extra careful and patient with where you put the colors, and even for certain layers, you'll need to wait till it dries or even use a blow dryer, which is a little bit more of a hassle sometimes. But of course, I still love watercolor, and they both have great things about them. Gosh, this has to be my new favorite medium. I believe you can buy this palette from Amazon called Himi Gouache, and I haven't used other palettes before, so I can't really review or compare it, but the colors are really nice, easy to use, and I mean, this palette is just really aesthetic looking. So I'm just blending the leaves here, making sure they're not too blotchy looking, making sure that they're blended in. I'm using a Copic marker to draw the lines and using the Crayola marker to draw in the face. Copic markers are just so satisfying to use because the colors are so strong and they go so well with paint. I actually got a bunch of these Copic markers in a pack for my birthday and I barely use them, so I'm really happy that I'm able to put some use on this because it goes so well with this. So again, I'm using Crayola marker on the face just because it's easier to draw on with the Crayola marker and it's not too heavy. I didn't record this, but I did go back to add some texture in the background with Crayola markers and small details on the leaves with Copic markers. It was really fun to paint. This was my first completed gouache picture. Thanks so much for watching! I was actually super sleepy and felt a little bit blue during the recording. Hope you guys remember that it's okay to feel blue sometimes and congratulate yourselves whenever you are able to pull through. Every little achievement counts and we're in this together. Anyways, see you next time! Bye bye!